feel like I'm confessing to a crime right now. I didn't like Happy Place by Emily Henry.
Huh?
So, earlier this year, I read Happy Place by Emily Henry, and I was expecting to love it. Because so many readers I follow that I really like their book recommendations, this is one of their favorite books. This is one of their favorite authors. And this story did not click with me at all. And I felt like I was a little broken after finishing it. The miscommunication trope just drove me insane, and I just didn't really connect with any of the characters in here. But her writing alone made me want to give her another chance because it was gorgeous. I loved it. So I decided instead of completely giving up on Emily Henry already, I'm gonna give her two more chances. I went on Goodreads and Amazon and I figured out the highest rated Emily Henry books and I picked those up. I really didn't look into the plot at all. I went solely off the review. So without any further ado, let's start on Emily Henry's second chance. My second chance with Emily Henry. I feel like she's way more important than my one opinion. So let's get some reading done. I like it. It's really good. I've been close to tears a few times already. That maybe because it's that time of the month, but who knows, really. I'm just gonna say it's the book. I am really liking this. I'm having a great time. It's making me smile. It's making me feel the nice romance book feelings.
I love love.
There hasn't been any spice so far, which I didn't think there would be that early. I think there is some in here, but we'll get to that later down the line.
Yes, spicy!
To give you a little summary of the book before I start talking more about it, we're following January as she's going to live at her dad's lake house for the summer, at least, and she is in a writing rut. She is a novelist. She's written romance novels before. It's kind of cute to have a romance novelist write about another novelist. I feel like we're getting a little taste of Emily Henry in this book, more than her other ones, in a way, because she is writing about an author. But it's been really sweet so far. You're following January. She's trying to write this book, and she's been in such a struggle and hasn't been really wanting to write a romance book. And then her college rival actually ends up being the one who lives next door. Some stuff happens, yada, yada, yada. They reconnect and they strike up this deal. Augustus is a Augustus is a literary fiction author, and I will be calling him Gus for the rest of the time because Augustus is too long of a name for me to say. They decide to strike up this deal where he's going to try to write a romance novel and she's going to try to write a literary fiction because both of them are just having the worst writer's block. And they are going to try to not just write it, but then sell it to their publishers. They're trying to learn like the trades of the different author world. I don't know much about writing books. They're doing like little side quests and stuff like that, and it's very sweet. I wasn't expecting it to be so cute, and honestly, I wasn't expecting this book to really pull me into the Emily Henry world, but I think it has. We'll see if it continues. I feel like we're just now starting to get into the actual like romance side of it, so I'll see if that's where I fall off with it. Honestly, I'm just gonna curl up for a little while longer before I go to bed and keep reading this. Not my heart going pitter patter. 150 pages down. I'm gonna go read some more. Catch up with y'all tomorrow because I'm gonna go to bed here really soon because I am an old soul. All right, game plan for today. We're gonna try to be an aesthetic romance reader today. AKA, I'm gonna go read at a coffee shop for a while. And then I'll check out some bookstores. I feel like that's what all the romance girlies do. Feels like what the girls do in Emily Henry's books, so let's go. Beach Read, and I freaking loved it. I had such a good time reading this book. I already told you basically the summary of it in the last clip, I'm pretty sure, but we basically just continued with those characters. I loved it. The side characters were so good. The little plot twists we got throughout the book were really good. I literally gasped at one point, which I don't normally do with romance books, but this one got me with one of those plot twists in there, so I'm so happy about that. It's just set in the cutest little Michigan town, and I love it, because cute little Michigan towns are the freaking best. Her writing, just like in Happy Place, is phenomenal. It is beautiful. It is lyrical. It is stunning. I love the two main characters we're following this one way more than I like the ones in Happy Place. I didn't connect with them, and they kind of ticked me off in that book, but this book, I connected with both of them on different points, and I just really loved them, and they just, it felt right and not forced, and I wasn't confused by the whole plot of the whole book.
Well, that's on you.
This one just made sense. It felt like real life, and I loved that. I adored that. With all the good stuff being said, this does have two spice scenes in it. They're very easy to skip. I don't even think I had to skim over anything. I just skipped them. No problem. Figured out where they ended very easily, and we were set to go from there. Oh, also, her girl best friend in this is so cute, and I love their little relationship, and it just feels so real as a older adult relationship, and I loved it. They were the sweetest friends. I love a good friendship in a romance book. Honestly, those relationships almost more make it or break it for me than the main relationship sometimes. You gotta have a good core friend group for our main girl, or it just doesn't work as well. And this just did everything so well. Compared to the romances, I have rated 5 stars. It falls a little below that, but not too far. I'm gonna rate it right at a 4.5. I really enjoyed it, and I cannot wait to get into my next book. And hopefully I enjoy this just as much, and Happy Place was just a flop for me. It was not a flop for everyone else, and that's great. Love that. But it was for me. So hopefully our next book, Book Lovers, is just as good as Beach Read, and I cannot wait to learn about these little kids. Yes, let's just get some reading done. I don't know what else to say. I don't know what to really expect. I haven't even read the back of this book, if I'm being honest. I kind of avoid the backs of the books. Don't know if that's a good thing or not. Probably not. I am wired right now. It is like 10:30. This is my bedtime. I'm normally ready, fully ready for bed, lying down, about to fall asleep right now. I only got 20 pages in and I got distracted.
Pull yourself together, man.
But let me just show y'all the state of this book. Firstly, you can see it on the cover. That's pretty bad, but I ordered it off of Amazon. We're expecting some scratches, unfortunately. Like, this is page 5. What is that? What is that? That's gross.
Ew.
It looks like it got run over, then thrown, and then dropped in the ocean. I don't know. I'm only 20 pages in, but I think I'm gonna like the vibes of this book. And we're just gonna get into some delusional reading time. I'll catch up with y'all tomorrow. Can I do a cool transition? Just go. I'm over 100 pages in. I'm having a good time. I'm just a little bored. And I don't think it's the book's fault. I think my attention span is just really bad today. I don't really know what to do about that, but you know, we got a little workplace rivalry in here. Small town tropes, kind of. How do I describe this? We got a big city girl in a small town who ended up running into the other big city guy she already knew that is from the small town, and now there might be something happening there, but there shouldn't be because they are coworkers, and that seems like an HR nightmare, but yeah, it's all for the sake of the book. For the plot. Sorry for the bad lighting, but it is starting to storm outside. I just got back from running some errands, and I am so ready to just cozy up and read for the next few hours. I love stormy reading weather. It is so good. Beef. Why does she keep leaving her sister every chance she gets? Like, girl just keeps disappearing.
And Poofy just disappears, just gone?
This is a vacation for y'all to reconnect, and you just keep leaving her anytime she even looks at a man? Libby, pull it together. Also, stop calling her sissy. I don't like it. I don't like reading it. I don't like hearing it. And I just, every time I read it, it sounds like a 5-year-old child in my head. No offense if you called your sister sissy, but I cannot imagine doing that to my sister on a regular basis. Like, it's not just a cute little nickname. She says it constantly. I would lose my mind. Besides that, everything's been good. I've liked the love story's been really sweet. It's been, I don't know if slow burn's the right word, off and on. I don't know. It's been something. I think I like it. I only have about 80 pages left. I don't know exactly how all of this is going to settle together. There's a lot more going on in this one than just the love story, it feels like. It feels like that's almost a B plot in this story, which I kind of like. I feel like we're really focused on our main character in every aspect of her life, and the love interest just kind of fits in there. I'm really enjoying it, and I'm dying. And it's almost 10 o'clock, and I'm a little tired, but I'm not actually, so I may stay up and finish this. I really don't know. I'm excited to see how this ends, though. I am. I'm actually very excited. It's been a really cute small town setting. They've been help fixing up this little bookstore that his family runs, and it's just great. But they're both actually big city people. It's a fun little twist on the small town romance, and I'm really enjoying it.
I love it!
Overall, I'm liking it. I just don't relate to these characters as much as I did the last one. She does write like little anxiety moments and panic attacks really well in her books. I don't think they're, I would call it basically a full-fledged panic attack in here, but she doesn't make a big point of it. She just writes it really well, and you know what the character is feeling, and I really love that. Hopefully this ending doesn't ruin the book for me. I don't think it will, though. It's been really sweet. Libby is the worst sister. Oh my gosh. There's been a lot of psychotic behavior in this book, but that's not okay. That's not how people act. That's not how you should act as a person. I only have 40 pages left, but it's late and I am too overwhelmed, so I'm putting this down and I'm going to bed and I'll finish this tomorrow because, heck, I don't know what to say. Okay, what am I talking about? My blood sugar is really out of whack right now, but I think we're good. We're gonna talk about the book that I just finished because I didn't have anything else to do when my blood sugar dropped. So I read the last 20 pages that I had left and it was, oh wow, okay.
Disgusting!
Ew! I think my copy that doesn't look like it got run over and has random stuff in it got in today, so I will be replacing all the tabs and highlighting the lines that I wanted to highlight and returning this piece of garbage. But the words on the inside were still all readable, and I did go ahead and go through it, and I really enjoyed it. This was a great comeback week for Emily Henry, oh my gosh. So, just a brief recap before we get in. No, we'll do.
Oh no.
No, I'm so out of it. Anyways, brief little recap of this. You're following Nora is our main character's name. Completely forgot about it. You're mainly following Nora and her sister. Nora is our main character and Libby's in a lot of this story. Like I said earlier, she keeps just like jumping out of scenes for no reason. She's just like, oh, you're talking to a man, bye. Libby, please, you are in a random town. Stay with your sister. Libby doesn't do that. Nora doesn't die. This isn't a murder mystery because Libby left her in the middle of a small town, in the middle of nowhere with a random man. It's actually a nice little romance story that ended so well. I will say, besides Libby just making some questionable choices, the sister relationship in this is so, so sweet and really had me tearing up at the end. And I just, yeah, my heartstrings are getting pulled on and I love that. And just it's a really solid romance. I think this is my favorite actually, which is fitting because this seems to be a lot of people's favorite Emily Henry book. Thought I was gonna come out of this video with Beach Read being my favorite Emily Henry book because I really enjoyed this one as well, but I think that I like this one a little more, and this is already 4.5, so I think we have to get the five stars are also 4.5, but I really, really enjoyed it, so we're gonna give it a 5 stars. To note with Emily Henry though, she does have some spice in her books. This one had less in the spice scenes, but I wanna say there was an extra scene in here. So these both really even out to the same rating. This one had the least spice in it. Like I said before in this video, I just skip over spice, but they're not too bad. They're very easy to skip. Nothing's really hiding in there that you need to know. Now, focusing on the positives, Emily Henry has won me over and I will happily pick up some of her books in the future and I cannot wait to get there. Probably gonna be a minute before I pick up another romance because I'm more of a romanticy reader if I want romance, but I do love a contemporary romance every once in a while. They're just so nice and wholesome and easy to read. which I desperately needed right now. So these were lovely, perfect, amazing, 10 stars. I just had a great time. And I feel like that's what her books are. If you just want a great time, like if you felt like you want to watch a rom-com, but you just want to read it instead, here are her books. But they've got a little extra emotion in them. And it's just, ooh, I honestly started this video thinking I was going to end it still not liking Emily Henry. So I am very pleasantly surprised. Good. Good words. Good English. I'm very pleasantly surprised to find out I am actually excited to read some of her work in the future and just found another author that I really like that I accidentally just started off on a book that I didn't jive with. A lesson we learned today. If you read a book and you don't like that book that much, maybe you still like the author, so give them another chance. Anyways, with all that being said, please like, comment, subscribe, and I will see y'all next week. Bye, y'all.